We really appreciate it. I thank you for coming, and the chorus, the musicians, thank you for coming. Little token of our appreciation, after the concert, go right through that door. We do have some refreshments for you, some coffee and some finger food. So please feel free to join us afterwards. The chorus will be there, and you can talk with them if you like to. One bit of business I have to mention. That is one exit. In case we need to leave quickly, you can go out that door, or at the back of the church, you go out that door, and it puts you right on 2nd Street. In case anyone's interested, through that door is also the restrooms. You go through the door, turn right, and they're right on your right hand. And everyone, if you haven't done so already, please turn off your cell phones. If you need to take a call, please step outside so that your neighbors don't have to hear your conversation. This is the Charles Reed Memorial Chorus. And how it came to be, back in the 1960s, Charles Reed came to Point Pleasant Beach, and he taught in the high school and the junior high school. He was vocal teacher there. I happen to have been one of his students, and let me tell you that as an eighth grader, he scared me spitless. He was absolutely terrifying because he wanted us to do things right. He didn't care if you were a straight A student. Are you doing the very best you can do? Can you possibly do better? Then why aren't you? But he was a wonderful teacher. He taught many of us to love music. He taught us a tremendous amount about music. While he was in Point Pleasant Beach, he also started a choir for the adults in the community. And they were together for a number of years. When Ocean County College was founded here in Toms River, Charles was asked to be on the faculty as the vocal teacher. At that time, he brought his community adult chorus to the college, and they became the Ocean County College Community Chorus, OCCCC. But we had a wonderful time. We learned a tremendous amount of music. We did all sorts of music. We did Gilbert and Sullivan. We did opera. We did Gregorian chant. We did pieces that were commissioned for the choir. Actually, his son David is here tonight. Someplace, David? We sang with him, many people sang with him through the years at Ocean County College, and more than 20, possibly as much as 30 or more years ago, the hospice program started to have twice a year a service in Toms River Presbyterian Church on Hooker Avenue, and Charles asked members of his chorus to come and sing at that service. And a group of people continued to sing after he retired. Eventually, Jack Hudak took over direction of that chorus, and these, for the most part, are the people here tonight that sang the hospice services. Now, this group of singers, musicians, some of them are full-time professional musicians, some are amateurs that sing because they just really love music, love performing, love sharing music with other people. They come from Monmouth County, Ocean County, some as far away as, for example, Montclair in North Jersey. They come to sing here. And aside from music, what draws everyone together is love and loyalty to Charles Reed. When he passed away this past summer, the group of hospice singers that wanted to do additional performances chose to call themselves the Charles Reed Memorial Choir, because it's in memory of the lives he influenced and all that he taught us. He mentored many musicians. He led people on to careers in music. Other people became just very enthusiastic amateurs, but all joined by their love of music. He taught us a lot about music. He taught us a lot about focus and concentration and performance. And he taught us something that you might not immediately associate with music. He taught us moral courage, because he taught us you learn the music you're going to sing, you learn what you're supposed to do and when you should do it. You don't look at the person on your right or your left and say, oh, well, what are they going to do? You do what you know you should do when you should do it. You ignore the crowd. You do what you're supposed to do. And that was perhaps the most valuable lesson that he taught all of us. Now I'd like to introduce Jack Hudak, who's the conductor of this group tonight. Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here tonight. It's a little bit rainy out, but what a nice place to come and stay out of the rain and to feel comfortable and relax. And this comfort, this concert is going to do that for you, I hope. I want to thank Dorothy Massey and her husband, Ted, for inviting us here, and the good people of All Saints Episcopal Church and Father Juan. Thank you for having us. We're very happy to be here. The music selections you're going to hear tonight are special. They're songs that hopefully will help you to feel peaceful, to feel hopeful, and if you're hurting in some way, to feel healed. That's why the concert is named so. So we're happy you're here, hoping that you leave here with those senses of peace. Thank you.
Thank you.
next piece of music is called The God of Second Chances. A little while back when I was going through a difficult time, I came across this piece of music, actually for the second or third time. I've known about this piece for a long time, but it just kind of fell into me again. I have a recording of it, and I just started listening to it over and over again. And it was a tremendous help to me. It just brought me peace and hope. And it gave me the idea for this type of a concert, and I kind of built the program around this particular song. The words of this song are so important that I printed all of them, every last word of it, in your program so that you wouldn't miss a one. Okay, it's called The God of Second Chances.
Oh,
to sing. A few times tonight, this will be the first. The refrain, the words to the refrain are printed in your program, and Johanna will bring you in when it's your turn to sing.
Thank you.
introduction said a lot of things that I was going to say at this point, so I don't want to repeat anything. But I was going to mention a little bit about this choir and how it got started. She said that Charles Reed founded the hospice choir group back in the 90s, and many of the people here were part of that, and it's just grown from there. When Charles retired in 2000, he entrusted it to me, and I've had it ever since then. It's been a wonderful experience for me, and we've gotten a lot out of these memorial services. But a couple of years ago, some of these singers started saying to me, you know, we should sing more than twice a year. I always thought, someday. So this summer, I had the idea that, well, maybe that someday is now. Why don't we try to do this? So I called Kristen, my friend and accompanist. I said, you want to do this? She said, sure. I said, okay. Well, now we have a pianist. That's all we have. I didn't have a commitment from any singers yet. We had no money. We had no place to rehearse. And we had nobody to sing to. Other than that, we're in good shape. But little by little, I sent out an email, and it grew and it grew and it grew, and here we are, just a few months later doing this, and it's wonderful to be here doing this for you. But we did get our start doing hospice memorial services. So what I did, the next two songs you're going to hear, I took from those lineups. So these two pieces, the purpose of them, the intent of them, is to bring a little peace, a little hope, a little comfort to those that that have lost. Okay? And so this is what you're going to hear.
Thank you.
Ms. Necker, you are mine, is probably familiar to most of you. So we invite you again to sing along with us on the refrain. Words again are printed in your program. Brett and Fran will bring you in when it's your turn to sing on the refrain, okay? Thank you. Psalm 16, put this setting in here so you can sing some more. So this time you'll have Betty as cantor, and she'll bring you in on the refrain to this pretty song. Keep me singing. After that, Steal Away is a beautiful spiritual composed by David Haas. Two spirituals in the gospel stuff.
Oh, sister, let's go down, down to the water to pray. The trumpet sounds within my soul. I'm God wrong to stay here.
But he sent his wife and four daughters ahead on the steamship. And they left, and 4 days out to sea, the ship was involved in a collision with another ship, and within 12 minutes, the ship sank, taking most of the passengers aboard down with it, including Horatio Spafford's four children. Miraculously, his wife survived. When she got to Europe, she telegraphed her husband to tell him the horrible news. And he, of course, immediately booked passage on the next steamship to be with his wife in Europe. 4 days out into the journey, the captain of the ship called him up into his cabin, and he explained to him that at this very moment, they're passing over the place
where the ship went down, and his four children are right beneath him. At that time, Horatio Spafford went back to his cabin, and he penned the words to this song, "It Is Well With My Soul."
Thank you.
Church for opening up their doors to us. Father Juan, especially Ted and Dorothy. There are no tickets to buy. There's no entrance fee. There's no cost for this. However, there is a cost to us. So we're going to pass the plate. And if you'd be so kind and would like to donate something, proceeds to this will be twofold. Half will go to this beautiful old church and all the wonderful work they do here to keep them going. And the other half will go to the Charles Reed Memorial Choir, who would like to keep singing and doing concerts like this. So please be generous as you can and keep the music going. And I thank you in advance for everything that you've done for us, family members, friends, and your support. And we also invite you to